Okay, so let's move to some of the features that we were supposed to do. Last time around, we had seen the loan amortization schedule where it was pretty simple. Only 5 years were there. We were supposed to find the installment amount, principal amount, interest account, interest amount, and all those things. Closing balance would be zero after the payment of all the installments for all the number of years. Let's take some of the loan amortization, which are practically applicable. If you see some of the home loans you take for 15 years, 20 years, and you pay the monthly installment. So if you're going to prepare the loan amortization schedule manually, then there is a high chance ki aap wahan pe hi so jaoge. Because if you count the number of periods for which you will have to prepare this loan amortization schedule, will be 15 multiplied by 12. So it would be 180 periods. So obviously, manually, it will be taking too much of time. Here, if you know the formulas of IPMT, PMT, as well as the PMT, it would be pretty easy for you to solve this entire schedule without giving too much of gadha majuri kind of an efforts. So, sir, how we can do this? First, we need to identify that how many number of periods will be there in this question. So, for that, I need to share my screen. Let me share the screen of Excel file. Everyone, open your Excel file. Let's start reading this question. Now, this question will not be there in your Excel file, so you'll have to write it in the loan amortization worksheet. No worries, only four things are there. And if you don't want to write this, you can take a snap of it, and later on you can write it in your Excel file. As of now, you can take a snap of it. First thing you will have to identify over here is try to understand everyone. First, what will be the total number of periods in this case? Who will tell me? I hope everyone is able to see my Excel file. In this question, what will be the total number of periods? Everyone, let me know.
Yes, sir.
Yes, what will be the number of periods here? Read this question. Loan amount is taken for 50.
180.
Very true. So that needs to be established first. I'm copying the schedule so that we won't have to do it again and again. I'm copying it over here. Control V. Now, instead of this 5, we should have 180. And I have given you the trick in Excel, a pretty simple trick where you can write the serial numbers without writing the serial numbers manually. Sir, we will be pressing the equal to. Then select the cell. Then enter the sign of plus and enter 1 over there in the formula. So that means it will keep on adding 1 till the time we want that to do. So pressing enter, there is a 6. Now you won't have to do it again and again because that's the beauty of Excel. Just copy that formula. The formula range is going to be shifted. And we are going on, going on, going on, going on. To 180 periods we require. So let's see over here with how many total number of periods we have. I'm doing Control V. And what happens, my dear fellas and fellies, is that some people get stuck over here. We have one shortcut key in MS Excel. Say if you are there at 7, if you'll try to reach to the last cell over there, no, then it becomes really tedious task for you because you'll have to go one by one, one by one. So if you want to go to the last cell of the active data range, there is a shortcut key that is Control Down Arrow. Control Down Arrow 2 is to go to the last cell of the active data range. But instead of Control Down Arrow, if I would have pressed Shift Control and Down Arrow, then it would have been selected up to the last cell of the active data range. But here, I do not want to select the last cell up to the active data range. I want to go to the last cell of the active data range. So what I'm pressing, Control Down Arrow. So I'm there at the last cell. But still, we have 170. We are supposed to write 180 over there. So I'm writing 1. I'm copying it further. And till 180, we have done it. Right? So, sir, how can we make it look good? We want to do some makeup over here. Though I do not believe too much in the makeup. So how we can do, how we can select this entire table? Let's try to understand. See, I am there at the serial number right now. That is B23. If I press Control Shift right arrow, I will be able to select the last cell of active data range on right hand side. Right. If I want to select up to the last cell of the active data range at downside, then again I will be pressing Shift Control down arrow. So this entire table is selected. The active data range is selected. Now say if you want to apply the borders over here. So you have way number one. You can go to the home tab. In that home tab, you may go to the borders. Borders are given over here. You can select the all borders from there. But there is one more beauty about the Excel is that you can derive the shortcut key of each and every functions menu items which are prescribed in MS Excel by just pressing one simple key. Sir, what is that key? That sounds pretty interesting. Yes, there is one key starting with the sign of Alt. You can call it Alter, you can call it Alt, you can call it Alt. Many people pronounce it in a different way. So I've selected Alt. So to go to the home tab, this is one by one. Huh? It is not simultaneous pressing. So first I'm pressing Alt, then I'm taking the break, pause. Break ke baad. Now I'm pressing H. H is to go to the home tab. Now I am pressing B. B is to go to the borders. And now I am pressing A. A was the key denoted for all the borders. So all the borders are applied. If you are there with me, just give me a confirmation, else I should wait for you for 30 seconds or a minute. Shall I wait more, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, giving you 1 minute. Everyone do this quickly. Should I move ahead, all of you?
No, sir, 30 seconds.
Okay, more 30 seconds granted. Till the time students are performing the task, I am able to grant everything to them. I do not have any problem. But the moment student do not perform the task, then I face a bit of a problems. Keep doing that. So you are talking too much. We need 30 seconds in silence. Okay, I'm not talking now. Thank you. Okay, let's move on now. Can someone tell me what will be the opening balance at the period number one? If you can let me know. Sir, obviously, opening balance would be the total loan amount because we haven't paid any installment yet. So I'm writing 50 lakhs rupees as it is. Now you will have to tell me that to find the installment amount for 180 periods, which formula I should apply over here? Who will tell me?
PMT.
Absolutely correct. So starting with the sign of equal to PMT. Opening the bracket. The first thing we are supposed to write over here is the rate. Can someone tell me what will be the rate in this case? Fellas and fellies, nibbas and nibbies. All of you?
8%.
8%. Oh my God. 8% or something else needs to be written.
8 divided by 12.
Very true. Now people are getting awake from the nindra. So 8% is divided by 12, then pressing the comma, we have NPER, number of periods. We can write 180 over there. 180 is going to be same for all the periods. Then pressing the comma, we have the information related to PV. So, what is the PV amount? I'm putting the sign of minus so that we'll be able to have the positive answer over there. The PV would be 50 lakhs. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, comma. FV, which is an optional one, we do not have any information related to FV. I'm pressing 0, comma, type. So, in case nothing is given to you, we are assuming that the installments are paid at the end of each month. So, I'm writing 0 for end of the period, closing the bracket. So, my dear fellas and fellies, if you are taking the loan of 50 lakhs rupees and the interest rates is at 8% per year, the amount of installment you'll be having for 15 number of years is around 47,000. So the beauty of Excel is that you won't have to do it again and again. I can press Control C. फिर मैं नीचे जाऊंगा, नीचे जाऊंगा, और नीचे जाऊंगा, कितना नीचे जाऊंगा, सो जाऊंगा. अब तो नींद आ गई, अब तो बहुत नींद आ रही है. तो सर इसके लिए कोई उपाय है कि नहीं है? बेटा उपाय है. अब मैंने वहां पे कॉपी करके रखा है, सुनना बहुत मस्त, क्योंकि ये थोड़ी थोड़ी सिंपल सी ट्रिक होती है जो एक्सेल वगैरह में सिखाई नहीं जाती बट प्रैक्टिस करने से आती है. तो मैं यहाँ पे लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे गया. तो व्हाट इज द शॉर्टकट की? आई हैव टू गो टू द लास्ट सेल ऑफ द एक्टिव डेटा रेंज. नाउ इफ आई प्रेस द कंट्रोल डाउन एरो फ्रॉम हियर, नो आई विल रीच टू द लास्ट सेल ऑफ द एंटायर वर्कशीट. सो दैट विल नॉट सर्व द पर्पस. I am doing control up arrow again. I am going to the first one. There is a serial number because over there we have the active data cell range written, right? If I want to go to the last cell of the active data range over here, what shortcut key I'll have to press over here? Can someone tell me? Control down arrow, yes or no? I'm there at 180. So I'm doing a bit of a smartness over here. I'm going to the third row, third column. Now to select the cell up to the active data range at the upside, we have Control Shift up arrow. So up to this cells we have selected. Now you will have to just press the enter or press the Control V. I'm pressing enter and I have the installments amount. Okay, now can someone tell me if I want to find the principal amount from this, what is the shortcut key I have?
PPMT.
Very true. So equal to PPMT, opening the bracket. So PPMT is nothing but bifurcating the amount of principal from the installment amount of 47,000 rupees. As I've already stated to all my dear fellas and fellies in the last lecture itself, that when you have more number of years like 15, 20, 25, at that time, the principal amount in the initial years will be very less. Over a period of time, gradually it would be increasing. And the interest amount in the initial years would be too high, and over a period of time it would be decreasing. So PVPMT rate, again 8% needs to be divided by 12, comma per. Who is that per? PER. What's that per? Can someone tell me? What is the PER? If you can let me know. PER is the period for which we require the principal amount, right? So period will be nothing but one. So I'm selecting one. Why I am selecting this sale of B24 instead of writing one manually in the formula? If I would have written one manually in the formula, Nibas and Nibis, then what will happen? That one will remain constant in that formula. And in all the principal amounts over a period of time, this would remain one only. But I do not want one to be written over there. I want B24. Why? Because Excel changes the data cell range automatically. For the second period, it will automatically take 2. For the third period, it will automatically take 3. For the fourth one, it will take 4. And accordingly, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, it will keep on taking those serial numbers. So that's why I have selected the cell range, comma. Number of periods will remain same in all the principal amount formulas. So 180, that I can put manually, comma. PV will also remain same for all the periods, minus 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then comma. Future value, do not have any information related to that, taking 0 over there, comma. The last thing we have in the syntax is at the end of the period or at the beginning of the period. I would say at the end of the period, and for that I need to press 0. So this is how the syntax would be looking like. Closing the bracket, pressing the enter. I am not supposed to do it again and again. What I can do, I have already given you the path to reach to the last cell now. Do Control C first here in E24. Then going to the left hand side cell. Can someone tell me if I want to go to the last cell of the active data range downside, what can I press?
Control down arrow.
Absolutely correct. Control down arrow. Main baju mein chala gaya. Ab baju mein se fir se meri wali row pe aa jata hun. Ab main idhar aa gaya. Ab mujhe upar tak select karna hai. To kaun sa wala key hoga? Kaun batayega? Jeetne wale ko milega inaam. Ab upar tak select
karna hai. Control shift up.
Control shift up is the absolutely correct answer. Computer ji lock kar diya jaye aur aap jeet jate hain. Bilkul bhi kuch nahi, mere paas dahi nahi hai kuch. Pressing the enter, and you have the various principal amounts in that installment amounts. Now you have one more way to find this interest. Instead of using the IPMT, some of the fellas would be, sir, I am very smart, you know, I am doing this installment amount minus principal amount. So that's anyway going to be the interest amount only. So I said, Nibba, I know this, but I do not want to do this because I want to tell you the formula of IPMT. That's why I'm using IPMT. So starting with the sign off, equal to, again, opening the bracket. No, IPMT. Sir, aap to khade khade so rahe ho, mistake karte ho. Jata hai professor ki bhool nikalne mein to. IPMT, opening the bracket. The first thing we have is the rate here. Again, that would be 8% divided by 12. Not repeating this time around now. PER stands for the period. Selecting this one. Comma. number of periods 180, comma, present value minus 50 lakhs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, comma, future value I do not have, comma, 0 for end of the period, closing the bracket, pressing enter, won't have to do it again and again, control C, going to the left hand side, control down, again coming to our own, control shift up arrow, pressing enter, you have various interest amounts. Now opening balance is, now please everyone, I'm giving you the time of 1 minute. If some of the students are lagging behind, if you have any queries or questions till now, please let me know. सर ये एक मिनट में आपको बिल्कुल भी नहीं बोलना है क्योंकि हमें कंसंट्रेशन चाहिए तो कंसंट्रेशन में अलाउ करता हूँ कुछ भी नहीं बोलूंगा करते जाइए Keep giving me the confirmation if you are there with me, if you have done it. Otherwise, it will go on and on. We do not want to make this silence perpetual in nature. Let's start with the opening balance. The opening balance of the second period will be the closing balance of the last period. So I'm just pressing equal to, giving the link of this sale where closing balance is written. Sir, nothing is written over there. That's fine. Kabhi na kabhi to kuch likhoge na. Pressing enter. So here it is coming. Zero. So ye formula to har jagah pe apply hoga. Kyunki agar usko copy karke main niche leke jata hun, sir. So it becomes this. If you press the F2, no, you will be able to know that which sale you have linked with. So if you control C and do enter over there below, and over there on that cell, if you press F2, you will see that it's G26. So it is already getting shifted. That's what the beauty, that's called the relative referencing in the Excel. So I'm doing control C. बाजू वाले में जाते हैं नीचे पहुंचने के लिए फिर बाजू वाले का इस्तेमाल कर लिया फिर बाजू वाले को भगा देते हैं तेरा काम हो गया अब तेरी जरूरत नहीं है अब लेफ्ट में जाते हैं कंट्रोल शिफ्ट अप एरो अब प्रेस करते हैं एंटर तो हमारे पास हर जगह पे ओपनिंग बैलेंस आ गए सर कुछ नहीं आया जीरो आ रहा है तो बेटा फॉर्मूला अप्लाई किया है ना क्लोजिंग बैलेंस आएगा तो सब कुछ आ जाएगा इक्वल टू सर कोई बताएगा यहां पे हमें क्लोजिंग बैलेंस के लिए किस में से क्या माइनस करना होगा
ओपनिंग बैलेंस माइनस प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट
अरे भैया वेरी ट्रू सो ओपनिंग बैलेंस माइनस प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट द लोन रीपेमेंट अमाउंट यू हैव द क्लोजिंग बैलेंस प्रेसिंग एंटर यू वॉन्ट हैव टू डू इट अगेन एंड अगेन बिकॉज इफ यू डू कंट्रोल सी एंड पेस्ट इट ओवर देयर बिलो साइड सो यू हैव द फॉर्मूला अगेन अप्लाइड फॉर द रिस्पेक्टिव सेल्स सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग कंट्रोल सी बाजू में जाते हैं नीचे पहुंचते हैं बाजू वाले को टाटा बाय बाय सी यू कह देते हैं फिर से हमारे पास आ जाते हैं कंट्रोल शिफ्ट अप एरो प्रेस करते हैं अप प्रेस करते हैं एंटर सो एंड में अंत में हमारा आंसर आ गया जीरो मतलब कि हमारा कैलकुलेशन बहुत ही सच है नेक है अच्छा है परफेक्ट है इज एवरीवन देयर विद मी गिव मी अ कंफर्मेशन
Yes, sir.
Very true. Thank you very much. So this is how the loan amortization schedule would be looking like. 180, and we could do it without wasting too much of time. Next to that, you have one more worksheet of PPMT and IPMT. So over there, certain tasks are given to you. What I want is that I want you to perform those tasks. I'm deleting all the numbers which are there. Again, I'm deleting all the numbers which are written over there in the second one. So this is how it should be looking like. Everyone should be able to see that. That is the worksheet of IPMT, PPMT. Everyone, please go to that. Okay, here you will be using the IPMT and PPMT. There is absolutely no rocket science in that, that you have already done. But still, if you want me to do this, let's do that again. Say if we want to find the I interest, and for the first task we have over here is, everyone please read it out along with me. Find interest of the 12th period, compounding is yearly. So what we are supposed to find over here, I interest. So I'm using equal to IPMT. Opening the bracket, rate will be 12%, comma, PER would be the period, period would be 12th period because we want this for 12th period, right? So I'm writing 12 over there, comma, number of periods will also be in total 12 only. So again, writing 12 over there, comma, PV, that would be the amount of loan. So minus 1 lakh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros, comma, FV will not be there, comma, type will be zero, nothing is given. So we are assuming it's paid at the end of the period. Closing the bracket, pressing enter. So that is the interest period of the 12th period. Interest amount of the 12th period, sorry. Right? Now, let's take the third one. I'm doing this third one now. Try to understand that. You will be doing second and fourth one as a practice. I'm doing the third one. So third one mein jaate hai equal to sir pehle third dusre se to tisre ke sath 9 se fi kyun tisra bichara kabhi pehle aa jaye to kya problem hai aapko. So tisre ko dusra le lete ho, dusre ko tisra lenge is par. So I'm starting with sign of equal to IPMT, opening the bracket, 12% would be the rate. Now can someone tell me 12% needs to be divided by what in this case?
Four.
Very true. So I'm writing 4 over there, closing, not closing, comma, to go to the next parameter. PER, we want the interest amount of the 15th period. So 15th quarter ka hame interest amount chahiye, abich. So abich agar hame 15th period ka quarterly installment amount chahiye, interest amount. तो पीईआर में क्या आएगा पर वुड बी 15th एज सिंपल एज दैट कॉमा व्हाट विल बी टोटल नंबर ऑफ पीरियड्स इफ यू कैन से मी फ्रॉम दिस लोन अमाउंट लोन पीरियड
ट्वेल्व इंटू फोर
वेरी ट्रू सो इट वुड बी 48. Or you can write 12 into 4 as well itself in the formula. So 12 multiplied by 4 is perfectly fine. PV will be there, minus 1 lakh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, comma, no information related to FV, 0. Then we have the type, again 0. Closing the bracket, pressing the enter. So that is the interest amount of this particular loan. IPMT or PPMT mein kuch farak nahi hai. IPMT interest ka amount deta hai, PPMT principal ka amount deta hai. Ek sagi ma hai, dusri mausi hai. To mausi aur sagi ma dono same lagti hai. Thoda sa farak hai, IPMT ki jagah pe PPMT ho jayega. अब जो मैं आपको सिखाना चाहता हूं वो दूसरी चीज है, लेकिन उसके पहले मैं आपको 2 मिनट देना चाहूंगा, क्योंकि ये 2 मिनट में आप सेकंड वाला करोगे और फोर्थ वाला करोगे। कर दीजिए, मुझे आंसर बता दीजिए थ्रू द चैट बॉक्स इफ यू आर अनेबल टू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ, अगर आपका ईगो हर्ट हो जाता है तो। एंड इफ यू आर डन विद दैट देन वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन। आज चैट बॉक्स के साथ बहुत नाइंसाफी हुई है, चैट बॉक्स को कोई भाव ही नहीं दे रहा है, आई डोंट नो फॉर व्हाट रीजन। सो एवरीवन प्लीज पुट योर आंसर इन द चैट बॉक्स। धनंजय हैज गॉट इट, गुड। आर्मी हैज गॉट इट एज वेल, गुड। अगर सेकंड वाला हो जाए तो उसके बाद में फोर्थ वाला कर लीजिए। सर फोर्थ वाला में यह तो नहीं बताया कि इंटरेस्ट करना है कि प्रिंसिपल करना है। बेटा अभी इंटरेस्ट करो, प्रिंसिपल और पीएमटी आपके प्रैक्टिस के लिए घर पे। ओके, ध्रुवी हैज गॉट दिस, इवन चार्मी हैज गॉट दिस। लेकिन ध्रुवी और चार्मी के आंसर में कुछ फर्क आ रहा है, ऐसा क्यों हो रहा है? बाकी सब लोग थोड़ा वेरीफाई कीजिए। स्नेहा का आ रहा है आंसर फोर्थ वाले में 4 4 4 3। धनंजय का भी सेम आंसर आ रहा है, तो मेजोरिटी विंस। यस भाई साहब गरबा खेल रहे थे, आ गए वापस। ओके, कैन आई स्विच द स्क्रीन अगेन? Thank you. Okay. I guess this is the end of the lecture, but still I need to, because it will be taking hardly 2 minutes to explain, because I was supposed to complete the loan amortization today. Now we are supposed to find the cumulative interest. Everyone, please focus over here. Now do it at your home for your exercise. Everyone should go to this table. यहाँ पे ऊपर से मैंने ये वाला जो है ना उसको कॉपी करके बाजू में रख दिया है, इधर लग दिया है, कंट्रोल सी करके उसको पेस्ट कर दो। ये नीचे वाला तो आपके पास रहेगा। अब हमें ये करना है यहाँ पे कि हमें अगर कंपाउंडिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी ईयरली है तो हमें 5 साल का क्यूमुलेटिव प्रिंसिपल चाहिए। मतलब 5 साल के अंदर तुमने प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट कितना पे किया। इफ समवन कम्स टू यू एंड सेज दैट मिस चार्मी आई वांट्स टू नो दैट इफ आई विल टेकिंग द लोन फॉर से 12 इयर्स, आई वांट टू नो दैट In 5 years, how much of an installment or how much of a principal amount I would have been paid from the loan. So, till the end of the 5th year, what is the amount I'm making for the principal and what is the amount I'm making for the interest in total combined till the 5th year? Now, this kind of a questions may be relevant for you, right? Because sometimes you might know, you will have to know that, sir, if I'm taking the loan for the 15 years, then up to 5 years, how much of a loan amount would have been reduced? Up to 10th year, how much of a loan amount would have been reduced? So this is how you can find it. For that, you have the function called cum principal. So equal to C-U-M, P-R-I-N-C, cum prince. Prince beta, cum. So it's cum prince. C-U-M-P-R-I-N-C. Now this gives you a principal amount which is cumulative till the 5 years. Now what is the syntax? How the syntax looks like? I think for syntax I need to magnify a bit so that you will be able to get it. Just a second. Good. So we are here, right? In principle. So equal to cum prince. So now the syntax is visible to every student. Then in cum prince, I am going to write rate. Can someone tell me what is going to be the rate? The same one, 8% needs to be divided by. No, nothing. Nothing to be divided. What is the rate? 12%. Sorry. And it's yearly only. So we are not dividing by anything. 12%, comma. Number of periods would be how much? Can someone tell me? Total number of years we have? 12. Comma. Then you have the PV. PV will be minus 1 lakh rupees. Right? Comma. Start period and end period. तो मुझे पहले 5 साल का चाहिए भैया, तो पहले 5 साल का चाहिए, तो start period कौन सा होगा? 1. Everyone, please remain with me. Then comma. Then मुझे चाहिए end period. तो मुझे कहां तक cumulative principal amount चाहिए? सर, मुझे चाहिए 5वें period तक. So I'm writing the end period of 5, comma. And type would be 0 because this is going to be ordinary annuity. This is how the syntax would be looking like. Agar tumhe koi bole ki sir 6th installment se leke 10th installment mein main kitna principal pay karta hu, to tum yahan pe start mein 6 loge, end mein 10 loge. Agar koi tumhe bole ki sir 11th se leke 12th tak ये दोनों जो इंस्टॉलमेंट में पे करने वाला हूं 12 साल में, तो 11 और 12 उसमें प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट कितना होगा टोटल? सो मैं स्टार्टिंग में लिखूंगा 11, एंड में लिखूंगा 12. सो प्रेसिंग एंटर. सर, सम प्रॉब्लम इज अकर्ड. इफ आई यूज माइनस ओवर देयर, देन न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम इज कमिंग ओवर देयर. सो आई नीड नॉट पुट माइनस देयर. Please write 1 lakh. I need to check that why Excel is not accepting minus in cum principal formula. I need to check it out. So it would be there in the minus. And if you want to make it a positive, And what you can do, let me put minus somewhere at some other place. And no, I cannot put 12 as minus. The amount is correct. The thing is, it gives you the answer in minus in this case. Now, why it gives you the answer in minus, you know, as far as I can understand the logical outflow of this, it tells you that what will be the amount of loan that will be reduced from the total, right? So, this is nothing but the amount of loan that will be reduced from the total. So, that's why it gives you the answer directly in the minus. Ye amount aapko reduce karna hai to baaki ka amount isme mein lage. That can be the logic, but I am still not very sure about this. But in totality, the amount is correct. And if you want to find the interest amount, cumulative interest amount, then you have ICUM IPMT, cum IPMT. Instead of IPMT, you are writing cum IPMT. Right? Cum IPMT and cum principal. These are the two things you have. In the same way, you are going to apply this. But what is there that you will have to see that what is the compounding frequency from what period you want and up to what period you require. So this is how it would be from my side. Now this is something which you're going to practice at your home. And if you're facing any problems or difficulties, then just please let me know. Some of the students would be of opinion said that, sir, mid-sem examinations are coming. What will be the syllabus for that? The guidelines which I have given to you in the last message of our class in the Google Classroom, GC, the same guidelines you are supposed to follow. Some of the things that we had covered at that time would have been there. Or still, if you want, I would give you further guidelines regarding the syllabus coverage in that Google Classroom. By end of the day, I would give you the guidelines again so that you won't be having any questions related to the coverage of syllabus. Okay, so that's it from my side. Thank you very much, all of you. Just give me a 1 second. Sir, aap to har baar 50-50 minutes le lete ho.